and bids me at my Father's throne.
Bids me at my Father's throne. Make all my wants and wishes known.
God and Father, I am thankful for life. God, we all could have been in the grave with our harvest past and our summers ended, but in your loving kindness you have kept us alive so that we are still on the land of the living to make our wrongs right and crooked paths straight. Lord, those of us who have things to straighten out, help us to do so. God, bless these people that come. Some may be even coming for the first time, but tonight truth will be flowing all over this place. God, I cannot convict, I cannot convert, but the Holy Ghost does it all. But I want to do my job so well that the Holy Ghost can move mightily. God, I pray that every soul who has not yet surrendered, when they hear this message tonight, that their hearts will cry out, I yield. I yield. I can no longer hold out. I ask it in the name of Jesus.
In my immortal flesh, I'll rise to seize the everlasting prize and shout
the Lord. The coming of Elijah, the prophet. Let us turn to the book of 1 Kings.
1 Kings.
Yes, chapter 18. Yes, 1 Kings. And it is chapter 18.
18. Yes.
Yes. I
surrender. 1 Kings 18.
Yes, 1 Kings. And we are going to read verses 1 and 2.
1 and 2.
And then we are going down to verse 17 until I stop you. Yes.
Okay.
A lot of verses tonight. 1 Kings. Chapter 18.
18.
And we're reading from verses 1 and 2. And then we skip and go down to verse 17 until I stop you.
Okay.
Yes. 1 Kings, chapter 18. Everybody, after the 1, 2.
And it came to pass after many days that the word of the Lord came to Elijah in the third year, saying, go show thyself unto Ahab, and I will send rain upon the earth. And Elijah went to show himself unto Ahab, and there was a sore famine in Samaria. And it came to pass, when Ahab saw Elijah, that Ahab said unto him, art thou he that troubleth Israel?
Now hold on, folks, I'm not hearing your voices, and I know that the light is fairly bright. And I know you Trinidadians can read well. There's free education in this place.
Amen. Verse 18.
Everybody.
And he answered, I have not troubled Israel, but thou and thy father's house, in that ye have forsaken the commandments of the Lord, and thou hast followed Baalim.
Thou hast followed whom?
Baalim.
Yes.
Now therefore send and gather to me all Israel unto Mount Carmel, and the prophets of Baal 450, and the prophets of the groves 400.
Hold on. Wait. No, let us get this straight. Now, we that part again, Pastor. How many prophets of Baal? Come on, 400 and what?
450.
450 and another what? And 400. Now, that is how many?
800.
That's 850. 850 prophets. Move on. 850 false prophets. Move on, reader.
Verse 20.
Everybody.
So Ahab sent unto all the children of Israel, and gathered the prophets together unto Mount Carmel. And Elijah came unto all the people and said, how long halt ye between two opinions?
Mm-hmm.
If the Lord be God, follow him. But if Baal, then follow him. And the people answered him not a word. Then said Elijah unto the people, I only remain a prophet of the Lord.
Hold on, so how many prophets God had there? And how many Baal had?
850.
So it is 850 to 1. Move on. Yes, move on.
But Baal's prophets are 450 men. Let them therefore give us two bullocks, and let them choose one bullock for themselves, and cut it in pieces, and lay it on wood, and put no fire under. And I will dress the other bullock, and lay it on wood, and put no fire under. And call ye on the name of your gods, and I will call on the name of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
And the God that answereth by fire, let him be the God. And all the people answered and said, it is well spoken. And Elijah said unto the prophets of Baal, choose you one bullock for yourselves, and dress it first, for ye are many, and call on the name of your gods, but put no fire under. And they took the bullock which was given them, and they dressed it, and called on the name of Baal from morning even until noon, saying, O Baal, hear us! But there was no voice, nor any that answered. And they leaped upon the altar which was made. And it came to pass at noon that Elijah mocked them and said, cry aloud, for he is a god. Either he is talking, or he is pursuing, or he is in a journey, or peradventure he sleepeth and must be awaked. And they cried aloud and cut themselves after their manner with knives and lancets, till the blood gushed out upon them. And it came to pass, when midday was past, that the prophet sighed until the time of the offering of the evening sacrifice, and there was neither voice, nor any to answer, nor any that regarded. And Elijah said unto all the people, come near unto me. And all the people came near unto him. And he repaired the altar of the Lord that was broken down. And Elijah took 12 stones according to the number of the tribes of the son of Jacob, unto whom the word of the Lord came, saying, Israel shall be thy name. And with the stones he built an altar in the name of the Lord. And he made a trench about the altar, as